In the last video, I discussed the new machine groove setup in Mastercam 2023 on our chain guard signature part. Despite its advanced features and ability to support complex fixturing and jobs, not every project presents that level of complexity. One of Mastercam's biggest strengths is its ease of use and flexibility. After all, sometimes you just need to take a quick pass on a set of soft jaws, or quickly machine a basic contour and drill a couple holes in a plate to keep a job moving on the production floor. In this video, I'd like to show you that Mastercam 2023's new machine group setup still supports that flexibility that is critical for today's manufacturing challenges. Let's focus on this simple adapter plate held in the Lang self-centering 5-axis vise jaws. Clicking on the second view sheet, this isn't much more than a plate with two holes and a slot. Going through the process of defining fixturing, simulation settings, and even using a master model may feel like overkill. Simply defining stock, programming a toolpath, running verify, and posting this out might be all that's required. Let's see what that process looks like in Mastercam 2023. I'll click on Stock Setup. This launches the Stock Setup tab inside the new panel interface. Creating a bounding box, adding from a file, and picking a solid model from the graphic screen are all options. By default, Mastercam launches with a placeholder rectangular stock. I can add from a bounding box or right-click on the existing entry and edit the bounding box. Click All Shown and a 3D bounding box will appear on the screen. This can be adjusted by clicking on any of the six faces and dragging. All of the functionality of cylindrical and rectangular bounding box is supported here, but since we know the stock size we will be using, it's probably easier to just type in some round numbers. Since I will be holding this in a vise, put the origin of the bounding box at the top face. Make this 30 millimeters in Z to have some material for the vise jaws to grip. The back will be faced off in a second operation. Use 100 millimeters in X, 60 millimeters in Y. With the bounding box defined, click OK. With stock setup now complete, let's quickly explore some of the other options in machine group setup. Hovering over the tabs in the panel, notice I can also define a machine, master model, fixtures, tools, and simulation properties. Since these are all optional, let's keep this simple and overlook these for now. Click OK. From here, program a simple dynamic toolpath to rough the outside of the part. Select the dynamic toolpath from the 2D gallery. Using a From Outside strategy, select the top face as avoidance. Right-click in the graphics view and select the top plane. Click Preview Chains to visually ensure that the chains are selected correctly. The red and black region represents the material the algorithm will remove. Click OK. On the tool page, select the 10 millimeter end mill. On the linking page, set the depth associated to 2 millimeters below the bottom face of the part. Ensure that Generate Toolpath is on and click OK. With the toolpath generated, let's verify the results. Launching Verify, notice that the bounding box stock we defined in Machine Group Properties comes in as defined. Although for the most realistic and accurate simulation, I would always recommend defining master models and work holding, this machine group does not have them. Simply because they are undefined, these items are not used or accounted for. And for this simplistic part and process, I'm okay moving forward without them. Mastercam 2023's machine group setup contains powerful benefits in a clean, organized new interface. But if you have a simple part that needs to get done as quickly as possible, Mastercam remains flexible to work in a way that best suits your needs. After all, Mastercam is renowned as one of the easiest cam systems on the market to use, and the functionality of machine group setup helps to also make it one of the most powerful.